Just bought the new Galaxy S7 or the Galaxy S7 Edge and you want to know how to get the most out of it? Well, here's our quick guide to the best hidden features and some little tricks that you might not know about. How to use the Galaxy S7 or S7 Edge comfortably with one hand. The S7 is already pretty comfortable to use one-handed, but if you're still struggling to operate it without both mitts, or you opted for the supersized 5.5-inch S7 Edge instead, then check out Samsung's one-handed mode. Just head to the settings and then scroll down to Advanced Features. In here, you'll find the one-handed operation setting, which gives you two different options. Reduce screen size squashes the usable desktop down to the bottom portion of the screen when you triple tap the home button, while one-handed input moves the keyboard to one side of the screen. How to free up storage on your Samsung Galaxy S7. If you go to the Galaxy S7 settings menu and scroll down a bit, you'll spot the Smart Manager tool. This is a simple phone management app that can help to clear the clutter and keep your S7 nice and clean. Tap the storage quadrant and you can perform a quick and dirty cleanup by poking delete. You can also scroll down a bit and tap details, which shows you exactly what files and apps are taking up all of your valuable space. Don't forget that you can actually install a microSD memory card in the S7 and the S7 Edge 2, up to 200 gigabytes. Then just head to the settings, and then storage, and then used space. From here, you can copy apps across to the memory card, freeing up valuable storage on the S7. How to record your games on the S7. Samsung's Game Launcher tool can be used to record any games that you play on the S7 or the S7 Edge, complete with video commentary from your good self. Just tap the Game Launcher icon, find the game that you wish to record, and give it a tap. Then, when you're ready to record, just tap the icon in the bottom left and hit Record. To stop again, just give your avatar a quick tap. How to use two apps at the same time. If you want to watch a cheeky bit of YouTube as you check your emails, then the Galaxy S7 split-screen multitasking mode will be your best friend. Just tap the Recent Apps button beneath the S7's display and you'll notice that many of your open apps have an icon that looks a bit like two rectangles. Tap this icon on one of the apps and it'll pop up to fill half of the S7 screen. On the bottom half, you'll see another list of apps. Give one of them a poke and it'll open in the bottom half. You can resize the windows just by dragging the white circle between the two apps up and down. How to get rid of the annoying Samsung Update News widget. The Update News widget, which appears when you swipe right from the Galaxy S7's home desktop, is pretty rubbish, but thankfully it's also quite easy to disable. Just find a blank bit of desktop space and press and hold your finger on it. The desktop will shrink away and you'll find yourself in the edit mode, where you can add widgets and app shortcuts and so forth. Flick right until you see the Update page and you'll notice a toggle at the top which simply reads Update. Tap this once and the Update page will disappear. Job done. How to disable Samsung's always-on display. Another not-so-hot Samsung feature on the S7 and the S7 Edge is the always-on display, as it doesn't support third-party notifications from the likes of Gmail and WhatsApp. As you'll therefore end up constantly activating the screen to check for these notifications, you might as well disable the always-on mode to save a bit of battery life. To do this, just pull down your notifications tab by dragging your finger from the top of the screen. Then repeat the motion to pull down all of your power options. Tap the Always On icon and the Always On display mode will be disabled. Disable Quick Charge to prevent battery overheating and damage. The Galaxy S7 and the S7 Edge support Samsung's adaptive fast charging to quickly power up. But if you usually charge your phone overnight, we'd recommend turning off fast charge to avoid any potential overheating issues or long-term battery damage. To do this, just head to the settings and then to Battery and then scroll to the bottom. You'll find the fast charging cable setting right at the bottom. This is enabled by default, so just tap it once to disable it. Got any S7 tips and tricks of your own? Just give us a shout in the comments below.